Hi, Sean here from Email Experts. We help e-commerce brands grow via email and automated marketing. And in this video, I'm going to go over lists and segments in Klaviyo. This is one of our most requested topics. In this video, I'll go over what lists are, what segments are, and how to choose when to use lists or when to choose a segment. Lists and segments are super powerful tools in Klaviyo. They have some similarities, but despite them being under the same label in the side menu, they have very different purposes. You may have heard people say that lists are static and segments are dynamic, but what does that actually mean? So let's start with the easy one, lists. A list is simply a place where you can put your subscribers. Customers join your list through forms on your website, pop-ups through the checkout, competitions, or other forms that you set up, or by importing subscribers directly. So here's how you set up a list. Within Klaviyo, under Lists and Segments, click Create List, click List, give it a name, and that's it. Now your list is ready. You can connect it to a sign-up form, or you can upload contacts directly. And if you'd like to learn more about using sign-up forms and pop-ups, check out our video in the description. At Email Experts, we recommend you have only three lists. One, the list for your sign-up offer. If you have a 10% offer, set up a separate list for this and use this to trigger your welcome series. See the video in the description if you want to know more about connecting forms to your list and subscribe, because we'll be making a video soon about how to set up a welcome series too. The second list is a list for your checkout. Connect the checkout to a list. And thirdly, your other list, so newsletter or subscribers. This is a list to add subscribers to when you need to import them. Even if you don't do this very often, it's rare, we still recommend setting up this list. So to summarize, lists are buckets where you can add subscribers. Subscribers are added when they subscribe and are removed when they unsubscribe. So now onto segments. Segments are a way to look much deeper at your subscribers and understand how they behave and target them with precision. Unlike other platforms, Klaviyo segments are not a subset of your list. Segments are pulled from across your whole account, all of your subscribers. So there are a few ways to segment your subscribers. Firstly, by something they've done or haven't done, so purchased or clicked or that sort of thing. Secondly, by something they are or somewhere they are. Thirdly, by something Klaviyo predicts, so if you have the data. Or if they're on a list. Yes, you can make a segment with a list. So let's go through them. Something they've done, such as buying, browsing, or opening emails. Two, something they are, somewhere they are. These are any profile properties about the subscriber. So this could be the country or state that they're in, their name, or even their birthday. Or something Klaviyo predicts. Klaviyo has predictive analytics. If you have a small store, Klaviyo will allow you to predict their gender based on recent US census data and your customer's first name. If you have a larger store, Klaviyo will also allow you to predict churn rate, likelihood, and likely next purchase date. And the really great thing about segments is that you can combine rules. So let's jump into an actual demo of how to make a segment within Klaviyo. So within Klaviyo, go to Lists and Segments, and again, just go to Create List or Segment. Click on Segment, and imagine, for example, that you're a Californian brand and you want to win back disengaged customers with a discount. So you can combine the different rules, as I said. So let's say we want Californian women who haven't bought recently. So we want to say something that they have or have not done. So we want to say that they've placed an order at least once over all time, but they haven't placed an order recently. So they've placed an order zero times in the last, let's say, 60 days. So now we also want to stack on top of this a rule about where something about them, where they are. So property about someone, we want to say state. And you can see all the great Klaviyo metrics that we can get here. So state equals California. And we also want to add a rule about something that Klaviyo predicts about them. So predictive analytics about somebody. Because this is a small store, we've only got predicted gender. And so that's the predictive analytics. And the way that Klaviyo determines this is based on US census data and your customer's first name. Keep in mind that it's not going to be perfect. And so you might decide, rather than saying likely female, depending on your audience, you might want to say is not likely male. Still, make sure that your message that you create with this is not super gender specific, that it's going to upset somebody if they're being misaligned with a, you know, gender ambiguous name, for example. So this would give us our segment. The other thing that I mentioned as well is that you should also include your main three lists as rules as well. So you click if someone is or is not in the list. So we'll choose our newsletter list. Or is in our Shopify Accepts Marketing list. Now, finally, we can also include a rule about is or is not suppressed. Is not suppressed. Now, it's good to add this rule as well, but don't stress if you don't. When you send an email, Klaviyo will automatically exclude suppressed and unsubscribed users from your send. So this rule is really here only to make sure that your segment has accurate numbers, and that's all. You can't accidentally send to subscribers who have unsubscribed. Klaviyo won't allow you to do it. So then you click Create Segment, and Klaviyo will calculate, and then it will show you. Now, I won't show this here for privacy reasons. So when should you use a segment? Firstly, when you create a campaign, consider whether the content you're creating is relevant to all subscribers or just a subset. If it's a subset, then probably go with a segment. On the flip side, if you're having trouble coming up with content ideas, make some segments. This might trigger ideas for your campaigns. For example, if you've got lots of customers who haven't bought in a while, send an offer, or make a segment of people who have bought but haven't bought a specific product. They might not be aware of that product. So when should you use a list and when should you use a segment? So when you create a sign-up form, you have to connect that to a list. You don't have an option. When you are creating a flow trigger, then I always recommend using a list. It is possible to use a segment, but segments don't always calculate exactly in real time. So someone might subscribe and meet the rules of the segment, but there might be a delay before they trigger the welcome series, for example. So I recommend using lists, and especially since you're already connecting the sign-up forms to the lists anyway, I recommend using the list as the trigger there. For campaigns, you can use lists. There's no major issue with that, especially if you just want to send to everybody. But I do recommend using segments because you can combine all the lists into one segment. And also you can make audience segments. And the amazing thing with audience segments is you always get more engagement if you make targeted audiences. And Facebook audiences, again, you can make a list of Facebook audiences, but again, I recommend using segments for Facebook audiences because it allows you to do much more granular and more targeted Facebook audiences for your seed audiences, for lookalikes, or as an exclusion audience. Lists and segments are great tools for you to use in Klaviyo to better understand your customers and target them with email marketing. I hope you found this useful. If you have any questions, please leave them below. If you like this content, we'd really love if you'd subscribe and keep an eye out for other videos we make. Good luck, and we look forward to seeing what you build.